Hey y'all, Bite Size Bible in a Year, Chronological Edition, April 23rd. Welcome. We are reading in 2 Samuel and 1 Chronicles. You need the specifics? Then you check down there in the description. I'll have today's and tomorrow's reading in there, or actually yesterday's reading, which is what we're talking about today, and today's reading, which we'll talk about tomorrow, both in the description. Today is going to be a shorter video because sometimes you just need a short video. I think Wednesday is a good day for that. So you're welcome. Okay. Remember, David is now the king over all of Israel. He tried to bring the Ark of the Covenant back to the city. That was a fiasco, but he's learned his lesson here in 2 Samuel and 1 Chronicles 15, and he's gathered the Levites, he's gathered the priests, and they are carrying the Ark back to Jerusalem the way that it's supposed to be carried and by whom it's supposed to be carrying it. And so we also see that David is dressed in a linen ephod, and he is dancing and praising God, which his wife did not like because she thought it was beneath his dignity. But it just shows his level of worship and love for the Lord. So you might have been confused about a few things. It says that he built a place or constructed a place for the ark, a tent. And you might have been thinking, I did not realize that the tabernacle was in Jerusalem. It wasn't. It was still in Gibeon. It was there until the time of Solomon. And so he built, this is David's some other kind of tent. It's made out of curtains for the ark. You might have been confused why he was wearing a priestly garment, our translation says. Some other translations say a linen ephod. And so that is something that people, priests would wear, but other people would also wear that are involved in some sort of religious activity. So it was David shedding his royal garments to put on a garment where he would be worshiping God, kind of saying that I am a king, but I will also worship God. And it was kind of a precursor or an illustration, really, of the Jesus who would come from his line, who was also a king and a priest. But he was not taking on the official priestly duties. But you might have been like, well, then why was he sacrificing? Well, when it says that David sacrificed, the priest probably did it. But David was, you know, sometimes people would go up and would say, okay, this person sacrificed to the Lord. Well, he brought the sacrifice, but the priest actually performed it. So that's probably what was going on there. I hope that was not too confusing. It was for me. I had to look it up and I was like, what was he doing? Why was he doing that? And so what we see the ark coming in. We see they put it in the tabernacle in Jerusalem. We see David writes this beautiful song of praise with his continuing theme of God being good and faithfully loving. And we see all the people worshiping at Gibeon. Also, they went back and worshiped at the tabernacle. And what I got from all of this was just the importance of praising God. It's so simple, but we forget it all the time. We get so tuned into this is what I need to do now, this is what I need to do now, this, and that. And then we forget we got to start everything with praise. I mean, David stopped in the very beginning of his journey to carrying the ark back to Jerusalem. He stopped and sacrificed and worshiped. And he's worshiping the whole way. And we need to do that too. Remember, the Bible says that we can't do anything without God. So we really need to be praising him, thanking him for what he's doing, thanking him for who he is. That's the most important thing. And praising him every day. So my challenge is this. Let's every day this week, what is this, Wednesday? So Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, for the rest of the week, let's take one action a day where we are actively praising God, whether that means we just wake up and say thank you to God, or maybe we write it down, or maybe we listen to worship music, or anything like that, some way that we can worship God, where we're putting our attention on God and thanking him for what he's doing. All right, that's it. So tomorrow, or today, is April 24th. The reading is down at the bottom, and we'll talk about it tomorrow. Farewell.